¿Qué te pasa, YouTube? Rockin Rodriguez coming to you today live. We're talking about Conga basics. We're going to cover a little bit of everything today. Four basic tones you need to know. First, the two drums I'm playing, they have individual names. This is the Conga Tumba. Could be called Tumbadora. What I don't have today is the Quinto. It's a smaller drum head, mainly used for soloing. Today, in most of your basic formats, a lot of people get away with just doing the two drums. You can do a lot. You need four tones to play. Your first tone you should learn is open tone. And you're going to use the part of your hand where your knuckles and fingers meet. You're going to strike the drum head at the edge of the rim, but on the half side of the drum that's closest to you. And you should come down and let the drum pretty much ring. Okay, so I'm going to give you a couple tones so you can listen to the open tone, and I'll switch over to both drums so that you can hear both of them sound nice and full, and there's a nice vibration. You're just letting the whole drum breathe. Okay, that's your open tone. You also have a bass tone you need to learn how to use, and that one you're going to use lead with the palm of your hand, and you're going to hit towards the center of the drum. And you could accentuate that bass tone by lifting the conga, or it could just be played with the conga resting on the floor. And you need to do this with both hands, just like you did with the open tone. And it goes like this. Your bass tone, okay? Muffle is the next tone you need to learn how to play. It sort of happens with the same part of the hand that you did your open tone with, but you may lead a little bit more into the center of the drum, because what you're trying to do is suppress the drum head, so you lightly press it before you release, so that way the sound is muffled, and choked out, if you will, and it sounds like this. Pair that with your open tone. Now I'm striking the drums at, I would say, pretty medium, almost a loud volume. So, but you don't pound the drum. You need to relax and use your wrist and just learn how to draw the sound out. Relaxed way. One of the most important sounds of conga playing is the slap tone. There's more than one kind of slap out there, and just like fingerprints, the slaps are your own individual sound. In fact, all these tones are. What makes this instrument very unique is no two congueros are going to sound the same. Now, the slap tone that we're going to use right now is we're going to use two hands to use the slap tone, and your non-dominant hand is going to lay across the center of the drum, slightly put pressure on the drum head to almost help change the pitch of the drum. And your right hand is going to come down in a slightly cupped shape. And you're looking for that crack, bullwhip kind of crack sound that's going to cut through the mix when you're playing. Okay, we'll compare that with your other sounds that you've been learning so far. In a few minutes. Listen here. And again, that's the edge of the drum facing me. Cupped hand coming down. And your thumb needs to be out of the way. Your thumb cannot be hitting the drum head at the same time as the fingers. It's raised out of the way, if you can see that. Let me see here. I'm going to move a little bit so you can get a closer, better view of that, where my thumb is at. Okay, my thumb is slightly up, raised up. You see that? Now you should be able to do this with both hands, all the tones on the conga. So let me give you a couple slap tones happening on both drums. So I'm going to demonstrate a few of the tones now, just so you can hear them back to back. Those are your four basic conga tones that you need to know how to play.